Hello and welcome everyone, Dante here. I hope you're all doing well. This is the second video of Gemini Man Warehouse Manager Tutorial Collection. It will focus on how to connect wireless debugging. If you have not paired your watch, facing connection issues, or not familiar with developer options, please go back to the first video, how to pair wireless debugging. Before I start, just to be clear, I'm using Samsung DeX, so my phone screen is on my computer screen. Right, so let's dive right in. Onto your watch, go to Settings, scroll all the way down to Developer Options. Scroll down and turn on ADB Debugging, and then scroll more and turn on Wireless Debugging. You can tap a bit or wait and then try to turn it on. Scroll down and you will see the IP address and port number to connect. Write them down if you prefer manual connection input. Stay on this screen. Now we're gonna open the phone application, go to WearOS Manager tab and press the connect. There are two ways to connect, automated and manual. For automated method, enter the IP address and press connect. Make sure the watch screen is active and is on wireless debugging screen. Enjoy the cat animation while the phone scans and identifies the connecting ports. Once found, you will see a pop-up message to confirm the connection. Press proceed and you will be connected. For manual method, uncheck detect ports. Enter the IP address and the connecting port you see on your watch. Now press start. You will see a pop-up message to confirm the connection. Press proceed and you are connected. If you have installed Gemini Man Wireless Manager on your watch, you can click on the Get the Watch IP Address. Doing so will get the watch IP address and autofill it for you. That way, all that is left is that you choose the method, whether automated or manual. Old Wear OS watches use debug over Wi-Fi. It requires only an IP address. Although there is a chance that wireless debugging is supported, debug over Wi-Fi was replaced by wireless debugging in the new Wear OS watches. To debug over Wi-Fi, you'll only need to keep the watch screen active and be on the lookout for a notice for an incoming connection. Once you have granted that, the phone has successfully connected to the watch. Wireless debugging requires you to keep the watch screen active during the connection or pairing process. Do not exit the wireless debugging screen to prevent the watch from entering doze state, which is a state the watch is idle and most services are halted to preserve battery. Sometimes the app connection is stuck. This is not an issue with the app itself, but the ADB is waiting for a response from the watch. You can replicate the problem by typing ADB connect command on your PC terminal while the watch screen is off or not on wireless debugging screen. ADB will hang for some time till it times out. To solve this problem, consider using a different network or simply restarting the phone and watch. You can also try to revoke authorizations on your watch to recreate ADB keys. For that, you'll be required to pair before you connect. All these can help in solving the issue. Keep in mind that a home network router might have a built-in firewall that can interfere with your ADB connection. And if you're using your phone hotspot, make sure VPN is off. If you have any questions, feel free to drop a comment below or reach me out on any of my social media. I'm more than happy to help. If you're enjoying Gemini Man OS Manager, consider sharing it with friends so more people can benefit from it. And just a reminder, as a developer who dedicates free time to creating apps and watch faces, everything I publish is completely free with no ads. So your support is highly appreciated. In the next video of the series, we will continue exploring everything Gemini Man OS Manager has to offer. See you.